This is Kiki of Supermom DIY, and let's make some pajama pants. So the pattern that I used was the Simplicity S0532. I got the pattern from Joann's. I only purchase patterns when they're on sale, so catch them when Joann's has their 99-cent Simplicity sale. If you sign up on Joann's, you can get a a notification of when the sale is happening. But you can also click the link in the description box to find this pattern for cheap on Amazon as well. All right, so let's go. This is 1 yard of fabric. You're going to put it right sides together, selvage to selvage. Selvage edge is that raw edge. Usually see like a little straight line on it. Then you're going to pin your pattern to the fabric or use pattern weights. My weights are really just super large washers from a hardware store. So I'm going to do that and play a little shuffleboard on my pattern. Yeah. Okay, next you're going to cut it with fabric scissors or a rotary cutter. Because I'm making long straight cuts, it's easier for me to use the rotary cutter. It's actually quicker. And if you're making more than one pair, you can actually stack probably 2 to 3 pajamas at one time and cut them. As long as you press really hard, you can get through all the layers because that rotary cutter will go through, I would say for flannel, probably about 6 layers of flannel, about 8 layers of regular fabric if you're making out of regular fabric. So you can cut multiple ones at the same time if you're making a few pair of these pants. So now you have your two pieces. You're going to take each one, put the right sides together, which is the printed side, match up that inner leg seam, and go ahead and pin that together. Make sure that you match your notches. Now, if you're interested in me doing a quick demo on how to cut out a pattern, like you doing the notches and all that, then just let me know in the comments below, and I'll do a separate video for that. Now we're going to sew down that inner leg seam. What you see on my machine is a walking foot. I like a walking foot because it moves the top and the bottom part of the fabric at the same time, so you don't have any slipping. You really don't have slipping with flannel, but other fabrics can kind of slip and then your fabric ends up not lined up as you're sewing. Next, you're going to set the seams, which just means iron them closed. Then you're going to open the seam and iron it again. And that's just going to actually strengthen the seam by doing that setting and the ironing. It also makes for a neater finished garment. Okay, so now you're going to turn one leg right side out, put your arm in there, kind of like a turtleneck, and then take the other leg and slide it on top. So what you end up with is the right sides of the fabric touching each other. So my Hello Kitties are touching each other. And you want to line it up at that inner leg seam. So make sure those two seams are together. Now that you have them lined up, you are going to pin at the crotch. So pin those two seams together at the crotch. Then you're going to take that entire crotch line and you're going to match and then pin the remaining seam. So all the way, like from the front of your crotch all the way around to the back, is what you're pinning. And make sure you line up your notches. That's just making sure you're on point with your pinning. So those should automatically line up. And again, you're going to use a 5/8 seam allowance. Seam allowance just means how far from the edge of the fabric are you sewing. So I'm sewing over 5/8 of an inch. You should have a little seam guide on your sewing machine, and then I'm just sewing it all the way around in that crotch area. From the rooter to the tooter. Okay, was that crass? Anyway. Now, information on this walking foot as well as the sewing machine that I use is also in the link in the description box. So here's where I'm going to get fancy on you. You can either sew over that crotch seam again. So you do want to either sew over it again, so two times, or serge the seam, because that's going to be the part that gets the most wear and tear, I guess you can say, from sitting and stretching and stuff. Now, I have a serger, so what that serger is doing is it's cutting the excess fabric and putting a serge seam, which is an overlocking seam, on the edge, which is going to reinforce that crotch. I done got fancy, y'all. I just got my serger a couple months ago, and I found a reason to serge any damn thing, okay? Sergers run, this one costs, I think, $186, so it's not super expensive if you want to invest. The link for details on that is also in the link in the description box. And if you are an avid sewer, I definitely suggest you invest in a serger, but also check Craigslist. A lot of people are selling theirs, and eBay as well. Okay, so you want to set the crotch seam as well, which just means iron it. That kind of sets the stitches into the fabric. So it's just further reinforcing, the sewing and the seams that you've done. All right, so now what you want to do is you want to, at the waist, we're working on the waist now, you're going to fold it down with the wrong sides together, a quarter of an inch. So you're going to do that all the way around the waist and then iron it. And you could just kind of eyeball a quarter of an inch. It doesn't have to be exact. So what we just worked on was the edge of the waist. Now you want to fold it down again an inch and a half. So just kind of eyeball it at first. And then you're going to take your ruler and fold it down. I kind of stick the ruler under there and fold it down to the 1.5 inch mark on the ruler, kind of pin it, and then just make that match all the way around the waist. What you're doing is you're making the casing so that you can put your elastic inside of there. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and iron that. I could pin it, but it's easier, especially with this type of fabric, to just iron it before I get ready to sew it. So now you're going to sew the waistband down at the edge. So we're not using that 5/8 seam allowance. And you're going to leave 1 inch open in order to be able to insert your elastic. And another thing is you can use a decorative stitch. So I used a zigzag stitch all the way around. But if you have some other decorative stitch, because this stitch does actually show, then you're going to want to use that. So now you can see the waistband has a little zigzag here. Let's talk about elastic real quick. You have waistband elastic and then the other kind. So the waistband elastic is the white, kind of what you find on draws. Sportswear is more comfortable at the waistband, or maybe comfort elastic. And the other kind, I use it, but I can't remember what I use it for. So anyway, use the waistband elastic. It's not going to be as tight. It won't have as tight of a stretch to it, so it'll be more comfortable around the waist. To measure, take your test subject, wrap it around their waist, and overlap it by an inch. Now what you want to do is insert a large safety pin into one end of your elastic, because you need to fish it through the hole. So now go fishing. Stick it inside that hole that you left in your waistband and kind of just inch it around till you get all the way around to the other end, but make sure you don't lose the first end. So you just kind of have to take your time and stretch it as you go around, kind of pulling the fabric till you get it all the way around to the other side. Now that you're around to the other side, you're going to overlap that 1 inch and then pin it so you can get ready to sew it. So kind of pull it to give yourself some room, and then you want to go ahead and sew. across on both ends of the overlap, okay? And then you do backstitch just to reinforce. So that's like sewing over it twice. And then pull your waistband to close the elastic and then close the waistband at the bottom. So you're going to use that same decorative stitch or plain stitch to go ahead and close that hole. Now, elastic does have a tendency to twist inside of this casing because there's nothing holding it. So you want to tack it at the front and the back. Tack it means just put a little stitch, stretch the elastic, put a little stitch in between it so that way it cannot flip around. Do this in the front and the back. If you're making adult pants, do it on either side as well to keep the elastic from twisting. All right, so we're getting close. Now we have to do the hem. So you can either serge the edge of the fabric or do that quarter inch fold over like we did on the waistband in order to have your seam finished and neat on the inside. Then you're going to determine your hem length based on the height of the subject that you're sewing for. So once you determine the hem, fold it up, iron it. And then you're going to sew close to the edge of the hem, so close to that finished edge, all the way around each leg. And now you're all done. So this is much cheaper than buying character licensed pajamas, which usually cost like $20 for a pair of pants. My children did say, well, where's my shirt? And I'm like, your mama's not making shirts. Go put a tank top on and keep it moving. But I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you want more DIY tutorials, you can head over to my Supermom DIY channel on YouTube. But also here, I'll start posting them here as well for those that are interested. So thank you guys. Have a great day.